Dear students, let us now discuss how to perform experiment number 213, that is bridge rectifier circuit. Here aim is to study bridge rectifier circuit. So here first of all, as you already have performed two experiments, half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier circuits, like those experiments, in this experiment also you are going to construct a circuit of bridge wave rectifier on a tag board. So I hope you people all are aware of how to use tag board soldering and how to solder the components on a tag board. So this circuit you have to construct with the help of four diodes. Each diode is having a number 1N4001. It's a normal rectifier diode, and there will be a transformer which you will have to use. So on the tag board you have to construct this bridge rectifier circuit using four diodes, and there will be one resistor which you have to connect as a load resistance between two opposite points, two opposite terminals of that bridge, and in between other two opposite terminals you have to connect the terminals of the secondary. So this is the simple circuit which you are going to construct. Extremely simple experiment is there. So after constructing this circuit on breadboard, you will have to switch on the AC circuit. That means the transformer primary you have to plug into the normal AC socket, then switch on. Then you are going to measure the AC input using a multimeter. AC in voltage at the input, and that will be nothing but the voltage between the two terminals of the secondary, between this terminal and this terminal. You have to measure, and that you have to record here, AC voltage at the input. Then you have to measure AC voltage at the output and DC voltage at the output, and that is nothing but the voltage between these two opposite terminals across this load resistance RL. So across this load resistance RL you have to measure with the help of DMM the DC output voltage, and now you switch on the DMM on AC voltage range, 20 volt range, and then measure the voltage between these two points once again, between same two points, AC voltage at the output. I will repeat, you have to measure DC input voltage, sorry, AC input voltage between these two terminals, this one and this one, across the secondary. That will be the first reading. Then DC voltage at the output, it is the voltage between other two opposite terminals across the resistor using DMM. For these two readings, the DMM should be set on voltage range 20 volt DC, and then switch the multimeter on AC voltage range 20 volt, and then you have to measure the voltage between these two terminals across this resistor and write down these. So these three measurements you will have to make, and after making these three measurements, with the help of this formula, you have to calculate VDC, which is 2 into VP upon pi. Now here VP is given by multiplying 1.414 to V in AC. There is a mistake here. So instead of V out AC to V in AC, that means to the first reading, you are going to multiply by 1.414 so as to get your peak voltage, and then to that you multiplied by 2 and divided by pi so as to get output DC voltage as per the formula. So these are the four readings which you will have to write down in the observations part. Then there is a brief theory given how bridge rectifier works, that you should know. Then write the component values actually used in the above circuit diagram. Then write the specifications of the transformer used in the above circuit. Normally we use a 909 transformer. If it is a three terminal, means if it is a center tap secondary transformer, it will be of 909, otherwise it will be of 0 to 9 volts. Then you have to draw input and output waveforms for bridge rectifier circuits. If possible, just as you have observed the waveforms for full wave and a half wave rectifier on CRO, you can observe the output waveform of this bridge rectifier circuit across the RL on CRO. So this is the way in which you are going to perform this experiment.